But Fox Marth is my personal favorite matchup to play and to commentate. It's just they basically both characters beat the crap out of each other. And that's, in my opinion, the best kind of melee. When they're both going in, you get one grab, you turn it into 75%, you get them off stage, you find your way to kill. It's just it's beautiful. Pure poetry.
This matchup is the epitome of melee, in my opinion. If not Fox Falco, but Fox Marth really showcases both sides of the field. You've got your spacey, and you've got your very fundamentally sound, traditional-style Smash character in Marth. Mm-hmm. Of course, the first of his kind, being that there wasn't a real true sword character like Link, you know, half projectiles and all that in 64. But this is such a wholesome, beautiful, fun-for-the-whole-family matchup.
Yeah, so let's see. This is... Yeah, it's basically Marth wanting to go into Battlefield, or you know, there's no real bad stage in this matchup for Marth or for Fox, really, except for maybe FD.
Right. FD and for Marth, probably Dreamland, even though it's not terrible. It's not very one-sided.
Yeah. I mean, a lot of Marths are sort of pushing the sort of thought envelope on that. Oh, my God. He almost got that hard read on the tech pattern. But, yeah, so it's going to be key for Timebones if he gets Fox in the air, as you see right there. Just keep using that up air, especially knowing when to vary between tipper and non-tipper up airs.
Yeah.
Because you just want to keep Fox close enough that you can follow up in the hit stun. But BlurpleKaz getting the first stock?
Yeah, so far looking pretty good, but bleeding heavy, 98%. Oh, no.
Okay.
No, I was not ready for that. I definitely got hit by that.
Yeah, That's the Ken classic. People know the Ken combo, but they don't know this man was messing around deep with the side B options. So I like that when you see stuff that you wouldn't normally see in this matchup. You know, you don't see very often the full side B, especially the fourth hit down.
Mm-hmm.
That was pretty crazy.
Okay, just going to block the get-up attack. Smart tech chases here from my man Timebones. He's just keeping it going, the pressure underneath the platforms. One of the things Marth really excels at, you've got that giant disjointed hitbox at your disposal. Why not poke through some platforms with it? Yeah, there we go. Covering both the high and the straight angles. Timebones knows this matchup. If you don't, I mean, what are you doing?
Yeah.
2018.
You got to know how to fight Fox. Particularly as Marth, but as every character, you got to know how to fight Fox. Oh my God, he went for this full Swanton Bomb.
I respect that so hard. If he traded stocks like that, he would have died a legend.
Yeah. Oh, he's going for it. A little down throw, down tilt. And is that going to be a stock? Yes,
Ooh-hoo.
It is. That is that delicious Gouda. That's all you got to do is just get Fox off stage without a jump. And as you mentioned, so many just gigantic hitboxes, disjoints, just makes it easy for Marth to clean it up.
The reverse up B, I'd say, second only to a side B spike with Marth in terms of style points. Maybe some of the crazy dares I've seen Zane do also and pivot F smashes. But, yeah, Marth definitely a character not short on style points and ways to accumulate them.
Yeah. Well, up smash deserves, too, to be in the
true.
Comments. If you get a good
Thundercats,
like, oh, my God.
If you land down smash, I mean, pretty much everything that's not like an F smash with Marth is fresh, right? And you can still make F smash hot by pivoting into it.
All right, so BlurpleKaz looking pretty grim here in game one. And I like that he basically was at... The only thing that BlurpleKaz could have done to avoid getting hit by that fair was short. Because once you hear that illusion sound, it's just you could put out a fair. If it tips, then you might be able to get a follow-up. If it doesn't, then you just get a weak fair, and they're back off stage.
And if it whiffs, there's enough lag that you're probably fine as Marth.
Yeah.
Don't have to worry about it. So it's going to be Timebones taking the first match, repping Ottawa. Please correct me if I'm wrong, and he's actually from the Montreal team, but I think he's Ottawa.
I'm trying to see what that headband is.
I think it's an American one.
I was going to say that. I think that that would be awesome if he was from Ottawa and was still repping the American flag bandana. Like, well, you're honorary American, baby. Yeah, you're in. Say the Pledge of Allegiance for me one time and we'll let you in. You don't even need a passport.
What if he doesn't know the words, man?
Oh, God. Oh, God.
All right. Well, here we go. We'll take an O Canada to make up for it.
So back to Battlefield. I guess BlurpleKaz just kind of saying, you know, I can get this done on this stage. And, you know, assuming that Timebones did ban Dreamland, there isn't any one stage that's going to be particularly great for Fox in comparison to the others. It's just personal preference.
Right. I think that's one of the most interesting things about this matchup is that Marth does have a hard counter pick in FD. But, of course, it's always going to be off the table.
Yeah.
Also, he could have picked Pokemon, but
yeah,
I don't know if that's Kaz's style. Damn, we see Timebones already pulling off to an early lead. going to go for this harassment under the platforms. Up airs, up tilts. Marth has so many ways to reach. Second stall, third stall. No, still not enough.
Yeah, so you actually have to be kind of careful when timing out those side B stalls. The closer you do them together, the more your vertical, or excuse me, your horizontal momentum shifts to zero. So that's why you saw Timebones actually not moving any closer to the stage. So you want to spread them out a little bit. I don't know the exact number of frames off the top of my head, but just spamming it, you'll basically just start falling straight down. And that's what happened with Timebones, that he was too far away to be able to come back.
Let's see. Very even game. Oh, gonna just go for back air. Wanted the raw damage, I guess, but I feel like up air, even though it wouldn't have killed, it would have put him in a way more precarious spot.
Ooh.
What?
Got him.
What did I just see? This guy is the side B master. Let's go, Timebones.
Oh, but he called him out. He charged that. He said, you're going right there in the center.
Sent him back in time.
All right, so dead even. And yeah, he just got dash backed. And sometimes it happens with your Fox playing against Marth. Sometimes you get a little antsy and Marth just does his little dance.
No. Oh, no, he did have a jump to touch ground. Okay, just plays possum right there. So smart by Timebones, throwing off the rhythm of the match. I think it's such an underappreciated aspect of this game. Yeah. It's like a dance or a song.
Oh, and, shit. Oh. Sorry, excuse me. That was
crazy. No, that was hype. But yeah, man, if you throw off your opponent's tempo, you can just make them second guess all of their actions. Like picture, you know, you're vibing in the club and then all of a sudden the DJ just like adjusts the speed of the beat by like 5 to 10 BPM and you're like, wait, what? Like all of a sudden your groove has just stopped.
Yep.
And Timebones, he used that to his advantage, unfortunately, had to lose a stock in the process, but now things are evened up. And oh, if he had gotten that tech chase, we could have seen so much damage, especially from the center where those platforms aren't there to interfere with your up throws.
All right, so can BlurpleKaz force a game three? It's always so scary to be in the side position as Fox above Marth on the side platform, because if you just get up tilted or you get up aired, it just starts a huge combo chain. So if I'm BlurpleKaz here, I just stay away from the side platforms.
Gets the flying up air and another on the tech. And, ooh, missed tech. Got the neutral air covering so much there.
Oh, God. That was so close for that nair to connect. And,
oh, DI'd in on the down throw. That could have been his life. Okay. BlurpleKaz still fighting here. Up throw. No aerial to follow. That platform being there is definitely a thorn in Fox's side.
Oh, and he got him on the last hit. Okay, you are officially crazy. And
officially dead as well.
Yeah, that's it. You could just roll up, but that's it. Kind of a back and forth game two there, as BlurpleKaz just with no regard for his own life, flying way off stage with that nair, did not connect and just got edgeguarded for it. And Timebones will take that to the bank every day of the week and twice on this beautiful Saturday.
Top 128 for him. Mm-hmm. Props. And that is a pretty deep run at top